In this video we are going to talk about how to find love. So before starting, please like this video and subscribe to this channel for our future updates. The pursuit of love can be so elusive that it can feel as if the search will never come to an end. Even when we are aware that it exists because others have it, the path to obtaining it can be so hazy that it is easy to give up the pursuit. There are no foolproof steps that will guarantee you'll find love, but if you follow the advice in this guide, you'll be on the right track. Just because the entire world appears to be obsessed with romance on one particular day in the middle of February doesn't mean you have to be, either. It's a nice reason to indulge in chocolate for singles who are content with their lives. Here are 12 suggestions to help you improve your chances. Number 12. Happy people attract people. Perhaps the most important aspect in your incapacity to find true love is the fact that you don't feel good about yourself in the first place. Schwartz recommended that you like yourself and your life, and that you put in the necessary effort to improve both of them. If you want to be taken seriously, you must present yourself like someone you would want to meet. Specifically, she stated that if you're not a joyful, pleasant, and self-confident person, you diminish your chances of being in an appropriate setting for the appropriate type of person. If you haven't been exercising, meet with a therapist to uncover the reason of your depression. If you haven't been eating healthfully, consult with a nutritionist to learn how to do so. Recognize that you have the opportunity to grow less shy if you are currently timid. It was Schwartz who described the concept of preparing for everything, including for love. The concept is that you have to train for everything, he said. You have the ability to improve your own condition. It is said by the author that until you are already dead, you are an unfinished creation. Number 11. The you'll find love when you're not looking approach may be wrong. In the words of Pepper Schwartz, a relationship specialist and sociology professor at the University of Washington, saying you'll get a job when you least expect it is like saying you'll get a job when you least expect it. Though possible, it is not something that happens on a regular basis. For the most part, she continued, those who are looking for a job are currently unemployed. In my opinion, it is merely an excuse for not wanting to go and put in the necessary effort. It does occur from time to time, but is not a recommended technique. It is not necessary to be desperate, advises Schwartz, which is consistent with the fundamental spirit of the proverb. While you should make an effort to locate someone, you should avoid acting as if any live being will suffice. Number 10. Go where people like the same things you like. According to Schwartz, you can opt to skip singles activities if they are not your cup of tea, but you must attend locations where you can meet other people. Become involved in politics via making new acquaintances on social media, attending meetups or joining social groups, volunteering for a cause that you believe in, or becoming more involved in political parties. The exact bare minimum you can hope for is that you're doing something you enjoy, and the absolute best case scenario is that you'll meet someone who shares your passions and interests. Schwartz advised people to take the plunge and try online dating in order to gain access to a wide pool of prospective matchmaking opportunities. If you're currently using a dating site, you should think about switching to another one. Number 9. Look up from your phone. Good guys and decent women can be found everywhere, says Bela Gandhi, a Today contributor and founder of the Smart Dating Academy in Chicago. If you know where to look, you will find them, she adds. Her surprise when individuals claim that they haven't met anyone leads her to believe that they then go out and spend the entire time staring at their phones or other technological devices is incredible. You should keep your attention focused on the present moment and scan the room to see if anyone else is paying attention to you. She explained that maintaining 3 seconds of eye contact with the cute stranger while wearing a grin on your face is an invitation for him to come over and chat to you. Number 8. Don't seek romance, seek partnership. When it comes to marriage, Tina B. Tessina, a California psychotherapist known as Dr. Romance and author of the book How to Be Happy Partners, Working It Out Together, says that romance is for dates and that it's wonderful to have on occasion in your marriage, but it's the relationship that will get you through the difficult times. It is not a good idea to hunt for someone who will fully catch you off guard. She warned, adding, that implies that you are a control freak, and you will not be pleased with what happens later. Try to find someone who likes a healthy interchange of ideas, who solicits and considers your advice, and who is also interested about what you want. Number 7. Take time to be by yourself. In the aftermath of a divorce or any other type of breakup following a long-term relationship, Nicole Barris-Foya, a divorce counselor at Start Over Smart in Westport, Connecticut, believes it's vital to take some time for yourself. According to her, it's necessary to take some time to yourself after a divorce or any other type of breakup after a lengthy relationship. As Foa points out, taking the time to recover, rediscovering your identity, and reflecting on what went wrong will put you in a better position to meet the right person. According to Foa, take the time you need to heal, spend alone time figuring out who you are again, and reflect on what went wrong. In this way, you will avoid repeating the same mistakes. Number 6. Instant sexual attraction often fades. According to Gandhi, the bulk of good love is a slow, steady burn that develops over time. Her belief is that you must experience attraction, but she does not believe that you must feel it instantly, since the initial spark is more about lust than it is about the elements that make great partnerships work. In his subsequent remarks, Foa asserted that people should be given a fair chance because emotions can change and evolve over time. If you would like to learn more about how to improve your relationship even if you have a good relationship, check the link below and make it even better. There's links to improve yourself, to become the best version of yourself, to lose weight and so much more, so please check out the links below. Number 5. Beware of the opposites attract theory. In spite of the fact that opposites are initially attracted to one another, they are likely to meet considerable friction points along the route. It is really easier and more advantageous over time, according to Dr. Gail Saltz, an experienced New York psychiatrist, to be in a relationship with people who have similar values. As a general rule, the greater the number of things on which you can agree, the less there is to dispute and compromise on. Number 4. Become a psychotic optimist. It means, in Gandhi's words, you must believe at all costs that you will find that particular someone. Love is designed for you and it will find you. All you must do is date like the Dickens till you find him or her. It is necessary to accept the process of dating, therefore, adopting a psychotic optimist frame of mind will make it more fun once you have been persuaded that true love is actually out there for you to discover will make the procedure more enjoyable. When it comes to dating, Gandhi recommends that you date 3 to 5 people at the same time until you find someone with whom you can be exclusively committed. When you're dating someone, it doesn't always mean you're sleeping with them, but rather casually getting to know them. Having sexual experiences should be postponed until you're in a committed, exclusive relationship, according to her advice. Thank you for watching our video here at Dr. Love Bug. If you find this video useful and informative, please like this video and subscribe. We just love and appreciate our subscribers. With you, we can keep the great information coming your way. Let's keep YouTube rockin'. Thank you very much. Number 3. Understand your own needs. Do you require a large amount of space? Do you want a lot of affection? Do you need to be aware of what is going on at all times? Whatever your personal style is, it's okay. Nevertheless, you must be aware of it and be able to convey it to your potential spouse. If you both know what you're looking for, you can coach each other, Tasina remarked. Number 2. Know the difference between a joke and a relationship. In the words of Tasina, you can screw around with anyone as long as you're careful and have safe sex. Before you welcome someone into your life, or before you give them money or living space, keep in mind that they are bringing baggage with them. She recommended that you make sure the person you're dating is being courteous in the beginning. It only becomes worse as time goes on, rather than better, so learn what's concealed before you get too far. Number 1. Stop pining for someone who is unavailable. Create an understanding in your mind that remaining with someone who isn't interested in you or who isn't there for you is damaging, and then go on. According to Schwartz, you have to think of it as a gigantic dark black pit that you have to get out of or else, you'll be buried in it. Please don't forget to subscribe and check out the links below. Our next videos are now here for you to enjoy. Thank you for watching us.